We will now take up a new structure in this chapter of morphology of flowering plants, and the structure is the fruit. We have discussed about the seeds. So ovule changes into the seed and the ovary changes into the fruit. The ovary wall will become the fruit wall. So ovary wall becomes the fruit wall. And fruit wall is known as pericarp. This pericarp is three layered. These three layers are known as epicarp, mesocarp, and endocarp. Now, when we see different types of fruits, we would realize that in some fruits we eat only mesocarp. In some fruits we eat all three layers. So there are various types of fruits. So the first thing that we will be taking is the brief classification. So all the fruits, they are divided or classified into three categories on the basis of from which type of ovary have they developed. So the first is simple fruits. Then the next category is aggregate fruits. And the third is composite fruits. Now, what is the basic difference? The first, that is simple fruits, they develop from the ovary of single flower. If one flower and its ovary changes into the fruit with or without any accessory part, then that fruit will be termed as a simple fruit. Aggregate, as the name tells us, aggregate means collection of. So here, the fruit develops from a polycarpillary, apocarpous ovary. What does this mean? Polycarpillary means there are many, carpillary. There are many carpels and all the carpels are free. That means every carpel is going to change into a fruitlet. So carpel becomes a fruitlet, and many fruitlets will together form an aggregate, which we call the complete aggregate fruit. Here the example is custard apple, so we'll take that up in detail later on, but there are tiny fruitlets which are there. All the fruitlets combined together make one fruit, and that is known as aggregate fruit. And in the third type, it is the complete inflorescence that changes into fruit. So in case of a simple flower, its ovary changing into fruit, it is going to be simple. Many carpels together form a fruit, then it is going to be aggregate. And if it is an entire inflorescence which is changing into the fruit, then we will call it composite fruit. Now, the simple fruits, they are further divided into two categories. On the basis of what type of structure they have, is it dry structure or is it fleshy? So, we would have dry simple fruits and there are fleshy simple fruits. As the name tells us, here there is no fleshy and pulpy part, that is everything is dry, whereas in this case something is fleshy, pulpy and juicy. Dry simple fruits are further divided on the basis of dehiscence. Do they rupture on their own or not? So if they rupture, then they are called dry dehiscent fruits. They are dry, but the fruit after complete maturation would dehisce, would rupture, releasing the seeds. Second, dry indehiscent. That means the fruit is dry, but it is also not going to rupture. That means the outer thing has to decompose to release the seed. And third category is somewhere in between these two. That means some parts show dehiscence and a little part may not show dehiscence. So some is indehiscent, some is dehiscent. Those are known as dry schizocarpic fruits. So this is how we classify the fruits. Simple, important questions which have been asked are, from which type of ovary do these fruits develop? Simple fruits develop from the ovary of a single flower. This thing is the important that we have to remember. Aggregate fruits develop from a polycarpillary apocarpous ovary. Polycarpillary, many carpels. Apocarpus means all the carpels are free. If such kind of an ovary develops into a fruit, then that would be termed as aggregate. Each carpel gives rise to a tiny structure which is known as a fruitlet. And all the fruitlets would combine together to make one fruit. That will be aggregate. And here, the complete inflorescence is going to change into the fruit. Now, that inflorescence could be a catkin kind of inflorescence, that could be hypanthodium kind of inflorescence, but the complete structure on which all the flowers were attached, that entire structure changes into the fruit. So we call it inflorescence changing into fruit. Then it is known as composite fruit. So this is how we classify the fruits. And now we have to talk about all these in detail. In case of fleshy fruit, something is going to be fleshy and pulpy. As I said, the three layers of ovary wall, sometimes mesocarp may become fleshy, sometimes endocarp may become fleshy, sometimes all three layers may become fleshy. So depending upon which structure is fleshy, which structure is hard, we would classify the fleshy fruits also. But in the next part, we will be starting with these three categories, that is dry fruits, dry simple fruits, if they show dehiscence or do not show dehiscence, and this is partial in between these two. What are the subtypes and their examples? That we will take up in the next part.